I'm sorry to keep you waiting so long to finish the album. I'm sorry. I've put it off a little bit. Not maliciously, there's just a lot of music to cover. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to UK finishing their album, their self-titled and debut album, UK, this time with the song Mental Medication, which was released in 1978. I apologize for keeping you guys waiting for so long. Like I mentioned, there's just there's so much music, you know? And I only release generally one video a day, so I don't like to just go through an album track by track by track and put it out sequentially in the day, because not everybody is going to want to watch that particular band or is interested in that artist or whatever. So I try to keep it somewhat varied. I know it puts things off. I apologize. Sorry. If I ever got to a point where I could put out like a lot of videos in a day, I would absolutely just blast through albums, you know? Because I could provide enough variety. Something's blinking on the screen and I have no idea what it was. Well, it looks like it's recording, so I'm assuming everything's okay. You guys can join me on Twitter. You guys can join me in the comments down below. Let's get into it. This is Mental Medication by UK.
Voice. You didn't give me no choice, you proved me.
Way to end the album. Also, by the way, was it me? Because my eyes were closed, but the lights went off. Like, while I was listening to the song, my internet's off and gone, so I'm imagining that the power went off really quickly. I promise I paid my bills. I definitely did. And I still have the pages up, so I can't look up anything, but I have the pages up, so I have my Wikipedia and the lyrics there. But that was weird. My eyes were closed and I was listening to the music and it kind of got blacker and I was like, wait, did something happen? Okay, anyways, interesting way to end the album, because this is the last song on the album after Nevermore. That's a beast of a song. I really like how in the intro, Wetton and Holdsworth on the guitar and vocals, how they kind of match each other. Wetton's just kind of playing on top of the rhythm that Holdsworth is creating. I like that little section there. It's a nice way to kind of bring in the song. And then even in that section, we have Jobson on the violin, kind of like very, very quietly behind it, but he's there. He's definitely there. And then Wetton just roars out as the song breaks into a definitely more progressive movement. And the verse really carries that spirit as it continues forward. This is a very progressive ending to the album. But even within its progression, it does have a lot of groove, has a lot of rhythm, has a lot of fun breakout moments between, you know, Bruford and Jobson. But it's halfway through the song that I feel like this song really begins to, like, show its colors. Like, it really takes stride in what it becomes. And then kind of blazing through these time signature changes, like, my mind's not ready for it just yet. I'm working into it, but my mind's not ready for it yet. But Holdsworth, the bass by Wetton. From here onward, this is soaring, guys. I like hearing Wetton playing bass the way he's playing it here, just furiously. Melodically, but just furiously. And like I said, Holdsworth on top of it, absolutely just awesome. And then even afterwards, we get some Jobson on the violin playing a little bit more. I mean, it's a nice trade-off between the solos. It sounds really good in that pocket that they've created. And this is a cool little build-up they got here. You know it's coming. I didn't know it was coming like that. Bruford kind of came in quick. And then, like I said, Jobson just carries it from there forward into that solo. That sounds really cool. That's nice. Oh, he's shredding there. He's shredding. This song feels like a jazz song if the jazz song was on meth. It has the spirit and the soul of jazz, but it's a lot more frantic and chaotic. I guess that's where the progressive rock part comes in. But they do it in a really cool way that comes across really cool. To be 100% honest, I didn't really love this song. Matter of fact, I didn't really like it that much. It's definitely not one I really enjoyed. I feel like they didn't really serve the song. They kind of just put in random time signature changes and put in random things, and they didn't really feel like they fit. I feel like they were there to throw off the song, but in listening to it, the song was thrown off. And maybe it's just my first time listening, so I haven't absorbed it correctly. I felt like the changes and the progression in it didn't serve the song, and that's something that I'm all about. I don't mind changes and transitions, abrupt or not, as long as the song is served and made better for it. I don't think that the song was made better for it. I think it was just kind of, okay, just felt unorganized. It felt cluttered. Like they were trying to fit too much in the last song on the album, when they've done so many great things beforehand. I don't know. This one didn't hit me the same way. The lyrics, mental medication, sweet music's conversation. Play for all creation here, melody fair. Lost in contemplation, drowned in meditation, need your inspiration near. When I'm alone, I remember truth is lasting. So is he speaking about how music is something that inspires us? And in a sense, music is mental medication for the mind. With the sun in your eyes and a simple disguise, you fooled me. Strange how your calling is clear. From the sound of your voice, you don't give me no choice. You move me. Deep lies desire for your quickening fire. And then I kind of skip to the end, which is repeated the first lines of the song. Mental medication, music's conversation. Need your inspiration near, melody fair. I feel like he's kind of talking about his muse. Whether that is a person or whether that is the music itself that inspires him. Whatever it is that inspires him and motivates him. Whether that is in his personal life or in the music himself that they create. I feel like that's what the song is about. Finding that specific thing that gives you that mental medication that allows you to kind of clear and free your mind, and you can always come back to it to make you feel good. Anyways, not my favorite song on the album, not the best way to end it for me personally, but I would love to know what you guys thought of it, because you guys may have loved it. Maybe you feel it was all right. Maybe you hated it. I didn't hate it, I just didn't like it. Regardless, I would love to know your thoughts, though, in the comments. You can also join me on Twitter. And I hope that you guys have a fantastic day. I hope you guys are having a beautiful morning, a wonderful night. Hopefully the coffee that you had this morning, the tea that you had this morning, is hitting you in just the right spot. Hopefully you got enough rest. Hopefully you got whatever mental medication you needed. Have a fantastic day, guys, and I will talk to you tomorrow. Bye.